Hey everyone, this is Dr. Kazi, and in this video, we are going to learn about what is the fixed dose regimen, also known as the time regimen, and what happens during the multiple IV or the oral medication. The drug dosage regimen, in very simple and easy word, consists of the frequency of the drug, the amount and size of the drug, as well as the route of administration. What is the amount and size of the drug? 5 milligrams should be taken, 10 milligrams should be taken, 15 milligrams should be taken, and what is the route of administration through which 5 milligrams should be taken? Intramuscular route, intravenous route, or the intradermal route. And what is the frequency of this medication? 5 milligrams should be taken once daily, 2 times a day, or 3 times a day. These 3 variables will determine the drug dosage regimen. Now, the drug dosage regimen is of 2 types, the continuous infusion type and the fixed dose type. The continuous infusion type, as we have discussed in the previous video, let's do a little bit of revision. You take time on x-axis and on y-axis, we have the concentration of the drug. Because it is a continuous infusion type, so the constant amount of medication is continuously infusing into your systemic circulation. Remember, there is no interruption. The drug is delivered continuously, so the concentration of the medication increases gradually until a steady state is achieved. During the steady state, the rate of drug administration is equal to the rate of drug elimination. The concentration of the medication in your plasma is constant. It is not changing. The continuous infusion, on the other hand, we have the fixed dosage regimen. The fixed dose regimen, as the name suggests, fixed amount of drug is given at regular intervals of time. So there is a constant fluctuation between the plasma concentration. It increases and then it decreases. Increases and then decreases. Between the dosing interval, there is a fluctuation or oscillation in the plasma concentration. Now, the fixed dose regimen can be given in 2 forms, either through the multiple IV injections or through the multiple oral administration. Let's talk about the multiple IV injections drug. You deliver the drug through the IV injections at regular intervals of time. Fixed amount of drug is delivered through the IV injections at regular intervals of time. For example, you inject 5 units of drug at 3 o'clock, then 5 units of drug at 6 o'clock, then 5 units of drug at 9 o'clock. So at regular intervals of time, there is a gap, there is a fluctuation, there is a gap, and there is no continuity when you are infusing the drug in your body. So we have time-dependent plasma concentration. It is fluctuating between the extremes and the means until steady state is achieved. Now, what is a steady state? Have a look at this diagram to understand it more clearly. Rate of drug administration is equal to the rate of drug elimination. The amount of drug you are injecting in your body, it reaches your kidney through your bloodstream. Now, the kidney is the major eliminating organ or the clearing organ in our body. It eliminates the drug, clear the drug from our body. So the rate of drug administration is equal to the rate of drug elimination. This is when the steady state happens. The concentration of the medication in your plasma is constant. It is not changing. Now, let's study how the dosing frequency affects the plasma concentration. Have a look. This blue line represents 1 unit of drug is taken 2 times a day. On the other hand, the red line represents 2 units of drug, which is taken once daily. Now, have a look at the fluctuations and the amplitude between these 2 graphs. The blue graph shows 1 unit of drug, which is taken 2 times a daily. So the frequency of the drug is high as comparison to the red graph, in which we have 2 units of medication, which is taken once daily. So we take time on x-axis, and on y-axis we have the plasma concentration. Let's discuss about this blue graph first. You inject 1 unit of medication 2 times a daily, 1 in the morning, 1 in the evening. So as soon as you inject the medication, the concentration of the plasma increases and it reaches 1 unit. Now, at the end of first dosing interval, some amount of drug remain in the body. For example, 0.5 units of drug remain in the body at the end of first dosing interval. In the evening, you again inject 1 unit of medication. At the start of second dosing interval, the concentration of the medication in your plasma increases and it reaches about 1 unit plus 0.5 unit, so it is about 1.5 unit. At this level, it is about 1.5 unit. Now, at the end of second dosing interval, the amount of drug in the plasma, it's about 0.75. This is the amount of drug which remain in the body after second dosing interval, at the end of second dosing interval. Now, at the start of third dosing interval, you will add this 0.75 unit with 1 unit, because you are continuously injecting 1 unit of medication continuously into your plasma. So you will add 1 unit plus 0.75 unit, and it is about 1.75 unit. So at the end of this second interval, the concentration was 0.75, and the peak of this third interval, third dosing interval, it is 1.75. So in the similar pattern, it follows, and the maximum concentration of the medication in your plasma, it reaches about 2 units when you are injecting 1 unit of drug 2 times a day. Now, the amplitude of fluctuation, it decreases when the frequency of the medication is increased. It is inversely proportional. Amplitude is inversely proportional to frequency. When the dosing frequency is high, the amplitude is decreased. The blue color represent the high frequency, dosage frequency, and notice the amplitude of this medication is low as comparison to this red graph, in which the dosing frequency is low. You are injecting 2 units of medication 1 time a day. On the other hand, you are injecting 1 unit of medication 2 times a day. So the blue graph, the dosing frequency is high, and this red graph, the dosing frequency is low. So the red graph have the high amplitude and the blue graph have the low amplitude. Now, what happens during the multiple oral administration? Have a look. You take fixed amount of medication through the oral route at fixed intervals of time. For example, you take 20 milligrams of medication at 3 o'clock, then again at 6 o'clock, then again at 9 o'clock. So you take fixed amount of medication at fixed intervals of time. The plasma concentration oscillates between the mean and the extreme, and it has the same pattern as the IV, multiple IV administration. Have a look at this graph. This blue graph represents the single fixed dose, and the red graph, which is oscillating between the mean and the extreme, it represents the multiple or repeated fixed dose through the oral administration. Now, the drug dosage regimen is used for two main purposes, for the loading dose and for the maintenance dose. The loading dose is when the serious infections happen in our body, or we have some complication in our body and we need rapid increase in our plasma concentration. So we need a rapid amount of drug, the huge amount of drug in our plasma concentration. So we have the loading dose. Now, there is a formula to calculate the loading dose. Volume of distribution multiplied by the desired concentration, the steady state concentration, divided by the fraction of the drug absorbed in your plasma. Using this formula, you can calculate the loading dose of the medication. On the other hand, the maintenance dose is to maintain the concentration of the medication within the therapeutic window. Now, what is the therapeutic window? It is the range of the drug in the safest and the effective dose with minimum side effect. This is what the therapeutic window is. You can calculate the maintenance dose using this formula. The targeted concentration in the plasma multiplied by the clearance of the drug divided by the fraction of the drug absorbed in your body. Using this formula, you can calculate the maintenance dose. This was all about the fixed dose and the time regimen, and I will see you in the next video. Please do like, share, and subscribe.